हेलो हेलो
हेलो। यस
यस सर, दिस इज रुवेन परेरा स्पीकिंग। आई हैव बीन
क्या?
लर्निंग विद दिस ईमेल फॉर ऑल योर लेक्चर्स। कैन यू सी माय रोल
हाँ दिस
नंबर?
हाँ सी या 7838। नो बिकॉज़ सी व्हाट हैपेंस इन रुएन। नो
यस
सो इट इज इट बिकम बिकॉज़ द अटेंडेंस। नो फाइनली नो व्हेन वी गेट द क्लास लिस्ट इन दिस
ओके
पर्टिकुलर रिकॉर्डेड एज पर द रोल नंबर। अंडरस्टैंड नो।
या बट
सो
नाउ
दैट्स
इट
व्हाई
इज
इट बिकम्स कन्वीनियंट फॉर अस
ओके बट
ना टू हैव रोल नंबर।
इज इट प्रॉपर नाउ?
अदरवाइज वी हैव टू कीप ऑन सर्चिंग। वी हैव टू डाउनलोड द लिस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर अटेंडिंग दिस एंड देन वी हैव टू मार्क। सो दैट बिकम्स वेरी ट्रबलसम।
बट
आई
इज दिस
होप
ओके नाउ?
यू डोंट माइंड। हाँ दिस इज परफेक्ट दिस इज परफेक्ट।
ओके थैंक
सर
यू सर।
यस हाँ बोला सचिन
सर
सर।
सर बरोबर
हाँ
है
एट
ना?
फोर
ये
नाइन से हाँ आता
आहे
दिसतोय
ना
तुझा रोल नंबर।
सर? आणि एक
हाँ
इश्यू झाला, क्लासरूमची जी तुम्ही इनव्हाइट लिस्ट पाठवली इनव्हाइट पाठवली होती ना, ती सर एका दुसऱ्या अकाउंटने चुकून लॉग इन
हाँ
झाली, कारण लॅपटॉप मध्ये दोन अकाउंट होते ना, एक नॉर्मल होता आणि एक तर एक्झामचा होता। सर आता रिक्वेस्ट पाठवू शकता का तुम्ही परत एकदा?
ठीक आहे पाठवतो।
चालेल, थँक्यू सर। क्लासरूमची फक्त
ओके
इन्व्हाइट पाठवा, त्या एक्झामचा जो ईमेल आयडी आहे ना त्याच्यावर फक्त पाठवून दे एकदा।
ठीक आहे।
सर स्टूडेंट्स आर इन द वेटिंग रूम।
Yes, Marty, pick something. All
Sir, I
right.
see
So,
my students
see, this
are
is a live. Right. See, this is a diagram. This I'll be this note I will share on the classroom. See, this is a diagram now. My process engineering is as the hub of the organization. So when it is 5 marks, this diagram block diagram is expected. Wherever possible, try to draw the diagram. So here you can see the process engineering is at the center. So the role of the process engineer is clear from this diagram. He has to interact with the product engineering. He has to interact with the purchasing. He gives the instructions to the purchasing. Then there is a separate department that is methods and work standards. If the company size is quite big, if the turnover is more, and if the number of products are also more, then there is a separate department that is called the methods and work standard. Methods and work standard, it comes under industrial engineering. So method and work study department is a part of the industrial engineering. It is so called as the method and time study. See, as an engineer, you have to do method study first, and then only you have to go for the time study. You cannot do time study first. In the interviews or in the oral, you should not tell like this. Yeah, I have done time study and method study. You cannot do time study first and then method study. First is you have to establish the method. You have to establish the method, a proper method, a proven method. And once the method is established and once the method is proved, only you can do the time study. So you have to say method study. So that's another department when the turnover of the organization is more. Then you have a tool and department which is exclusively meant for designing the tools. Now again and again I'm telling, the tool means it is cutting tools, it is mold, it is dies, everything. Even your jigs, fixtures, clamping devices, everything will tool design. You the brooch also, the diagram of the huge brooch. Then tool making and tryout. This department, what is the difference between tool room and a workshop? Generally, the tool room will have high precision machines, high precision inspection devices or inspection units. At the same time, the work slightly different, because every hour the parameter keeps on changing, the work keeps on changing. It's not the same. It's not in tool room. It's always a different. So you are always on the fit, on your feet. You know, it is very dynamic. Whereas in work, so I always like to work in a tool room. The work, nature of work is quite challenging. Every hour you appreciate yourself in terms of knowledge, that you keep on things. And there are many challenges also, because every hour someone making the mistakes, you know. And that's why as an engineer, you have to see that you give the instructions in.
Sir, the students waiting in the waiting room, sir.
Yes, so the parameter keeps on. So you should be capable enough to resolve these mistakes to take the decisions. So that's why in the tool room also, the people who are working should be experienced, should be qualified. Whereas in workshop, that being routine work, it is not essential to really have, you know, that every person should be qualified or skilled or highly experienced. Okay, so this I have uploaded on the classroom, these notes for the module 1. And here you can remember this also, so you can elaborate like product engineering. So what the product engineering department gives, it issues the product specifications, that is, it gives the part prints, it gives the engineering release, it gives the manuals or the standards. Manuals means your product manual, which consists of, you know, operation manual, then spares manuals, then maintenance manual, service manual. So these are prepared by product engineering. There are many times the big companies, the documentation, the manual preparations is so high, they have to employ nearly 5 to 10 engineers at the PG level just for preparing these manuals. No, because it is highly technical. Just 5 to 10 engineers only are working on preparation of the manuals. So the manual includes operation manual. That is, suppose if you are machine tool manufacturer, like suppose tomorrow you start manufacturing CNC lathes. Okay, so or if your turnover is very high, then probably you may recruit 2-3 engineers just for preparing manual, that is operation manual, maintenance manual, service manual, spares manual, electrical. All these instructions has to be given, and that has to be prepared by the engineer. Then now this tool design, so they have to, you know, prepare the tool, they have to design, they have to prepare this process engineering department. What he does, he prepares the designs, then he gives the orders. All right, then he also process pictures, and he passes those instructions to the tool design. Same, he whatever equipment specifications he has in his mind, he gives those instructions to the purchase department. Then whatever process study, sequence plan, whatever he has prepared, whatever methods he has established, he passes to the method study and time study. Right, so the method study and time study, they will establish the time. They will establish the time. What is the standard time? What should be the normal time? What should be the personal allowance, etc., etc. And then once that time is determined, they will come with a figure of cycle time and what should be the rate. So all that work is done by industrial engineering. Then they will have different incentive schemes. That is, suppose if the target is say 300 pieces per shift, if you are manufacturing say 320 pieces, then suitably the production staff is rewarded. That is, at generally it is at the worker level, the incentives or bonus are given proportionately depending upon the production. At the same time, the care is taken that if the production is down, that doesn't mean that the salary is cut. But as an engineer, you have to see that why the production is down, what is the reason. Was there any equipment breakdown, equipments were not functioning properly, or the raw material was not there, or the cutting tools were not there, jigs and fixes were not there. So that kind of study, or the peoples were absent, sometimes that also absent. Sometimes all of a sudden you have many peoples missing. Festivals, mean this is the headache to meet the production or to meet the target. And then when the tool design is ready, then those designs are passed to the tool room. So tool room will prepare the tool, they will take the trials, and if the trials are okay, then they will pass it to the manufacturing. That is nothing but the production. So at the center, process engineering is there. कशा म्हणजे काय बोलले. So that was the role of process engineering, and you can see that it is at the center, and that's why the process engineering is called as the hub of an organization. All right. So the functions of the product engineer, we have seen functions of process engineer also we have seen. So there is a difference between functions of process engineer and requirements of process engineer. Functions means duties, what he has to do. Okay, that is yes, to what work he has to carry out. That is, he has to determine the basic manufacturing processes, he has to determine the sequences, and he has to order toolings and gauges. And requirements, you cannot write the same thing, otherwise you lose the mark. The question which is asked is, what are the requirements of the process engineer? Then requirement of the process engineer, that you have to state that process engineer should be a qualified engineer. He should have basic technical education. Then he should have experienced in that particular domain. He should have knowledge of toolings, gauges. So like that, you have to write. He should be capable enough, or he should be able to do the estimations, he should be able to calculate the machining time. Then he should have a keen eye on cost reduction. So this is what you have to write in requirements of process engineer. You should not write the duties, because I have seen 50% of the students, they write duties in the question requirements of the process engineer, and then simply they lose the 5 marks. Another that is asked is, what is engineering release and ECN? So it sounds to be same, but these are different. One is your engineering release, and another is your engineering change note. So engineering release means issuing of the drawings or issuing of the plant prints. So what it does, engineering, it provides authority to process engineer to proceed. And engineering release is nothing but the issuing of the drawings officially. So that should includes your date, then part number, then part name, then model, then you should have material, then quantity, model number, sub-assemblies, everything. If it has some sub-assemblies, then that sub-assemblies has to be included in this engineering release. Then ECN is nothing but engineering change note. So engineering change note is prepared, and the engineering dimensions or the changes are done by the product engineer. So why it is required, sometimes the better material, then alternate material, then tolerances which is mentioned are not achievable, machines are not available. So process engineer prepares the request for ECN, and then the changes are done by the product engineer. So request for ECN, that is engineering change note, is prepared. Process engineer, see, remember this sentence. Process engineer prepares the request for ECN, and the changes are done by the product engineer. The other day, even Chetty was asking. So what it includes, engineering change note. So it has your request number, that is who has sent the request number, then when it is changed, that is change date, then how many parts in stock as per the old drawing, then details of the part change, what is to be changed, then reason for the change, and the effective date. So this is all is contained in engineering change note. Then this is a common question, that difference between product and process engineer. So again, you have to write appropriately what product engineer does. So product engineer, the basic is Like suppose if it is a 5 marks question, then you have to write, five differences. So product engineer is basically designed for manufacturing, and process engineer has to design the processes. So like that, you can have your own differences, right? Then determining the machining sequences is the most important duty of process engineer. But now this machining sequences means like this is in the domain when the product has processes called as the machining, but it is not necessary that every product will go through the machining. Like suppose if we have something called, suppose if we have a powder coating department, okay, so or a powder coating plant or a painting plant, so there will not be any machining, correct? So there in powder coating you will have receipt of raw material, then after receipt of raw material there will be some cleaning operation or buffing operation, or there will be some pickling operations, isn't it? And after that they will have, it will have some drying operation. Then it will go to the powder coating furnace, and then after that there will be some curing operation, like that. So powder coating or painting or surface coating or electroplating or hardening departments or hardening shops or foundry will not have machining. But since we have learned, manufacturing processes, production engineers, that is, since we are conversant more with the machine tools, that our focus is on machining sequence. Anybody wants to ask something?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay.
So, वो requirements of process engineer नहीं समझा सर. आप बोल रहे कि duties नहीं लिखने पर सर requirements of process engineer मतलब वो कहाँ पे required है ना? तो duties ही आएगा.
No, नहीं, not like that. Requirements of the process engineer means like I told that process engineer should be qualified. He should have at least a diploma in particular engineering stream or degree in engineering depending upon the job profile. Like he should be BE or he should be M.Tech. Suppose if somebody is working in say research and development, process engineer, or suppose a process he is working on the shop floor, then he should be minimum say diploma only. So that is the requirement. Process engineer should have a technical qualification. Okay. Then he should have experience in say machine shop or in say welding shop. So that is the requirement. He should be able to understand, or he should be able to read the drawings. So that is the requirement of the process engineer. So that is not to be mixed with the duties. Duties means, or the functions means, functions includes what duties he has to carry, and requirement means his eligibility. Like suppose if you want to take admission for engineering, then what is the requirement? That then the requirement is that you should have passed 12th standard, and in PCM you should have 50% marks, 145 out of 300. You should have cleared CET with non-zero marks. So this is the requirement. And then what are your duties as a student? That you should attend the lectures, you should understand the lectures, you should submit the assignments. This is the duties or functions of a engineering student.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. So this particular determining machining sequences means it is basically focused on the general purpose machine shop. But this may not be true. That is, that process engineer doesn't mean that he should be familiar only with the operation of the machines. So that is what I am trying to tell you, because you, if you have a fabrication department, if you have a painting department, if you have a hardening department, then there will not be any machining operations. But since this is a common, normally everybody has a machine shop, so that's why the more focus will be on machining. So now we will study this preliminary part pin analysis. The weightage for this is 10 to 20 marks. Weightage for this is 10 to 20 marks. So this is, these are the steps. It is also, short form is PPPA, that is preliminary part print analysis. And there are 10 steps which you have to write properly. So if it is a 10 marks question, it is asked, just write down the different steps with suitable example. And if it is 20 marks, then in that case, the component will be given and you will be asked, this is a common question. And it is, it always comes like that. Only there is a change in the drawing that perform the preliminary part pin analysis for the component shown. So we will do the preliminary part pin analysis for the trans bearing cage, which I have already shown to you that drawing. So once again, I will show you that drawing. Part trans bearing cage. Drawing I'll show you. Yes, so just have a look on this, study this drawing, so that it will be easy to perform preliminary part pin analysis.
हेलो
हाँ यस
सर, वो पीडीएफ था ना।
यस चलता ते तनाखान की ते 5 वर्षासाठी आहे 25,000. नंतर मी डिटेल मध्ये बोलतो तुझे. 5 वर्षासाठी भरायचं असेल तर थोडं आहे, नंतर डिटेल मध्ये बोलतो तुझे. तसं नाही आहे, मला त्याचा नंबर पाठव.
सर
यस हाँ, सो
सर, वो
विल
स्टेप
स्टार्ट विथ,
वाला,
हाँ सॉरी, विल स्टार्ट
सर
विथ
वो
दिस
स्टेप्स वाला पीडीएफ
एनर्जी.
आज क्लासरूम पे डाल देना।
हाँ, या सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप एंड देर आर सब स्टेप्स एंड देर आर अगेन सब सब स्टेप्स. सो यू नीड टू राइट लाइक दिस ओनली. You need to write like this. So first step is establishing the general characteristics of the workpiece. WP means workpiece. Establishing the general characteristics of the workpiece. So now in this you have general description of the part. First is. And in general description of the part, you need to write. First, I will explain the step, and then we will write it properly. That part name, part number, and function of the part. All right. So most of the things you will get it on the drawing. Like part name, you will get it on the drawing. Part number and function of the part. If it is not mentioned, then you will have to infer from the drawing. Right. So this it is. So here now, what is the part name? It is not mentioned, but then here it is. Part name: transbearing cage. It is mentioned, transbearing cage. Then part number, if it is not mentioned, you can give here. Part number is also given, 7685, and then you have to infer what will be its function. So that I will tell you how to infer. How to understand. Then next is B. So in general description of the part, these are the sub steps. Now B is your general configuration of the part. So in general configuration of the part, you need to write sub steps. That is, what should be the type of handling, then what are the machines required, then you have to list the tooling and list the sequence of operation, get familiar with some short forms, and then what should be the rate of the production, what will be the rate of the production. So this, all this comes under general configuration of the part. General configuration of the part, fine. So let's take an example of a bolt, and we are going to do preliminary part pin analysis for the transbearing cage. This is transbearing cage, and this is what is going to be your second assignment. Now I will give an example of bolt. Like suppose if there are, you know, bolts, number of bolts to be manufactured. So bolts, how it is manufactured? It's a forged blank, okay? And since it is manufactured in lakhs, it is to be rolled, thread rolling. So now you think about the handling and machines required. So now we are talking, we are speaking about some general board, general size board, means like say M10 or M16 by 50 mm long. We are not talking about the big bolts, you know, which are used in the pressure vessel. Big bolts means sometimes the bolts are as big as M100, means 100 mm dia, you know, and length is also 3 feet or 6 feet, 6 feet. one feet or two feet, so many long. If you visit the company called as the Industrial Engineering Corporation in Vasai, you can see such a very long, you know, bolts. So the to understand the type of handling, you need to understand the drawing first. You have to go through the drawing first. Then you can decide upon the type of handling. So now, coming to this, if the bolts are of this size, like say M16 by 50 mm long, then how you will handle? So you can keep those bolts in a bin, a small bin, like say 500 bolts or 1000 bolts, and you can keep that bins, like say 5 bins or 10 bins in a trolley, and the components can be handled. Then what are the machines required for the bolts? So for the bolts, first is your forging machines, which will give the shape of this bolt. Then in this forging, this head is formed, hexagonal or square or whatever it is. At the same time, this round diameter, this is also formed in forging. It can be hot forging machines or cold forging machines. Then it is passed to automat, that is single spindle automat, where it is turned, this diameter is turned. Again, SPMs, that is mass production machines. Then you have to do the thread rolling, that is, since it is to be manufactured in quantity, so thread rolling process also I will explain. And once the thread rolling is done, then you can go for inspection and so on. So this is what the machines required, list the machines required. Then next step is list the tooling. Now toolings will include cutting tools as well as the dies and molds also. So here you can say forging die, then you can say for cutting the threads you will need thread rolls, those are the dies, round dies which are used for thread cutting, and so on. Then some kind of jigs, fixtures, cutting devices, that is what you have, sir, to write. Yes, bolie.
Sir, pehle to sequence, list of sequences decide hoga na, kya processes karne, uske baad machines decide hoga na.
So sir, that operation sequence, that is a last step actually, but first, that 10th number step, you have to write it in the beginning. But before you write the, you know, sequence, you need to study the components properly. Understand? So slowly you will come to know. Just bear with me for some time. And then,
but sir, part dekh ke thodi na directly machines ka pata chalega. पहले हम लोग डिसाइड करेंगे ना पार्ट देख के कि क्या कैसे बनाना है, उसके बाद मशीन्स ऑपरेशंस
के एग्जैक्टली. हां एग्जैक्टली एग्जैक्टली. सो दैट्स व्हाई यू नो, दैट्स व्हाई यू हैव टू फर्स्ट स्टडी द पार्ट प्रॉपर्ली. लाइक हियर नाउ यू हैव टू स्टडी द पार्ट प्रॉपर्ली, इजंट इट?
ओके सर.
एंड देन ओनली यू कैन डिसाइड अपॉन द machines. So now here what I was telling, I was giving the example of bolts. So for the bolt, this is not in detail you are doing. It's not a postmortem, just a general. So bolt will have forging machines, will have turning machine, and will have thread rolling machine. That's all. You are just writing general details, you will do later on. That is the 10th step where you are writing each and every operation, and by that time you have studied the component in detail with the help of these steps which I am discussing now. And the list, the sequence of operation, that is also roughly you have to write, how to hold it, etc. That things you are not supposed to write here. Just bear. Then rate of the production, this is again a rough estimate that what should be the batch size, whether you are going to manufacture 5000 pieces per month or 10000 pieces per month. Then the step numbers, next step is material. So you have to write what material it is. These steps, you know, makes you familiar with the drawings, you know. Understand, that is whether you are understanding the drawing or not. Like whether you know the part name, whether you know the part number, whether you identify the function of the parts. So it makes you aware. It helps you in reading the drawing. Yeah, please.
सर वो जो भी हम लोग लिख रहे हैं पार्ट प्रिंट एनालिसिस सर वो पहले होगा ना मैन्युफैक्चरिंग के वो बोल्ट मैन्युफैक्चरिंग के
हाँ पहले पहले प्रीलिमिनरी पार्ट प्रिंट
एनालिसिस सर मतलब जो डिजाइनर स्पेसिफिकेशंस देता था वो है क्या वो कि मतलब स्पेसिफाई स्पेसिफिकेशंस ऑफ पार्ट
नहीं नहीं प्रोडक्ट इंजीनियर ने ड्रॉइंग दिया और इट हैज कम टू यू एंड नाउ यू आर स्टडीइंग दैट ड्रॉइंग सो हाउ टू स्टडी दिस ड्रॉइंग दीज आर द स्टेप्स
सर मतलब ये डिजाइन इंजीनियर बनेगा कि प्रोसेस इंजीनियर
प्रोसेस इंजीनियर व्हाट इज प्रिलिमिनरी पार्ट पिन एनालिसिस दैट इज द स्टडी डन बाय द प्रोसेस इंजीनियर
ओके ओके तो सर मतलब प्रोसेस इंजीनियर को इनपुट डायग्राम होगा
सॉरी
सर मतलब प्रोसेस इंजीनियर के पास जो भी मिलेगा वो सिर्फ डायग्राम होगा ना पार्ट का
दिस डायग्राम दिस ही हैज रिसीव्ड दिस ड्राइंग ओनली ओके
ओके सर
First he has written what is the part name, trans bearing gauge, what is the part number is 7685, what is the function of this part, he has to understand that there will be a bearing which will fit inside this and this will go in the housing, depending upon the tolerances, he has to just roughly guess, this is a guesswork, what will be the function,
yes.
Then what are the operations, there will be some operation drilling, then there will be some operation called as the milling, then boring, like that.
Yes, sir.
You have to just go on feeling. So when you will do, that time you will come to know. Understand the steps first. Then material. What is the material? So what is the material? Gray cast iron. So he has to just understand the drawing first properly. And how to understand the drawing first? So these are the steps. Then how the part is originated, so whether the part is originated from casting or from bar rolling. Now this particular component, now if it is a bolt, what is the, how the part is originated? By forging. This trans bearing cage, this, how it is originated? By casting. Understand?
Hello.
Then next step is recorded changes in design. So are there any changes in the design? So the design will be written down, so there are no changes, so he has to write no changes. He has to simply write there are no changes. Then resistance to the damage in the process. So resistance to the damage in the process means he has to identify, like when this material is being handled, you know, from machine to machine or from department to departments, you know, when it is to be handled, so what precautions has to be taken, so that he has to understand and he has to write. Like suppose if it is very thin walled component, like I have drawn it here, see, if it is very thin walled, if it is very thin bush, like say thickness is say 1 mm, or very simple example, like suppose if 500 eggs has to be handled, then there will be a particular kind of a tray, isn't it, which is designed for handling the eggs, and the trays will have pockets in which the eggs are kept. On that tray, another tray is kept which will have pockets, again in that the eggs are kept. Without this tray, you just imagine, can you handle eggs? No, you cannot simply dump the eggs like a bolts in a bin, isn't it? It may break. So if it is a thin bush, like say very small, 1 mm thickness or 0.5 mm thickness, then if you are, you know, hand, if you keep all these 10 bushes or 15 bushes in a bin, then the thickness will collapse. understand the bush will collapse. So maybe you'll have to prepare individual boxes, chota chota boxes, and in that you'll have to keep this bush with a mandrel, understand? So that the wall thickness will not, the component will not get distorted. So this is what you have to identify. And again, suppose now some components has a grinding finish here. So in the handling, you have to take care that grinding finish should not get damaged, that lapping finish should not get damaged. So maybe you'll have to wrap it in a bubble paper. So that kind of, inferences, that kind of understanding, you should have when you look at the drawings. And that is what you have to write it here. What are the, which areas will get damaged? That is what you need to identify and write. Yes, you are asking something.
सर एरियाज जो एरियाज डैमेज होने को प्रोन है वो लिखना है कि प्रोसेस लिखना है जो काउंटर करना
है नो दोस एरियाज प्रोसेस नहीं वी आर नॉट डूइंग प्रोसेस स्टडी राइट नाउ वी आर स्टडीइंग द प्रोडक्ट अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोडक्ट के ऊपर व्हिच एरियाज आर गोइंग टू गेट डैमेज व्हिच एरियाज आर इंपॉर्टेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ टॉलरेंसेस इन टर्म्स ऑफ सरफेस फिनिश दैट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई एंड यू हैव टू राइट Like I give an example of eggs. Okay, so eggs, if you simply dump it in a bin, it's going to break. So you have to have a tray. Now here, this bore, there is a suppose if there is a grinding finish here, and if there is a grinding finish here, so if you just dump like this, then that finish may get damaged. Understand? And sometimes the finishes are lapped finish or super finish. So you need to handle with gloves. With gloves, like foreign companies, vehicle assembly lines, Volkswagen. If you see in the final assembly line, nobody is allowed to wear belt. Nobody is allowed to wear a chain in the neck. Nobody is allowed to wear a wrist watch. Everybody should wear gloves. The gloves are cleaned every day, every shift. Why these precautions are taken in the finish assembly line? See, you must have seen vehicle ka, Volkswagen ka finish, how finish it is. You can see your face, you can see your mustache, you can see your hairs. So if somebody is wearing a belt, somebody is wearing a wristwatch, it can cause a scratch. So whoever is working in the final assembly line, in the finishing assembly line, the strict instructions are given that you cannot wear belt, you cannot wear wristwatch, you should have gloves. Why? Because they identify which areas can be damaged. Understand? Is it clear now? With yes, this example? Sir. Yeah. Okay. So this is what you have to record. And this is what we are studying. This is what is called the preliminary part pin analysis. Then the second step is auxiliary method of visualizing the part. See, we are going to take a case studies. This is going to be assignment. Like for the trans bearing cage, you write the preliminary part pin analysis. For the ball pillar, you write the preliminary part pin analysis. So all these nine steps, first you just understand what are these nine steps. And then we will take two components for preliminary part pin analysis. Now, auxiliary methods of visualizing the part. What happens? Sometimes the parts are very complicated. So simply the two views are not enough. Very complex drawings, the two parts are not enough. So in that case, you need to have a prototype or you need to have a 3D model. So if the 3D model is available, then you understand the part very easily. Like I can give you one example here, how difficult some parts are. Let me see whether I have it here, like this. So in this case, what happens if you have the 3D model or a 3D drawing. Now in this case, suppose if we have 3D model, then it becomes very easy to understand the product. With this, it becomes slightly difficult. Even this is average, but in this case, if we have a 3D model here, a CAD model, 3D CAD model or a prototype, it becomes very, very easy to understand. This is simple. So only these two views are enough to understand round job. isn't it? So here three dimensional model is not required. So this is what I mean by this step. Auxiliary method of visualizing the part, whether you need a prototype model or whether you need a 3D CAD model or you don't need. Sometimes if it is a cylindrical job, then even one view is also sufficient, like a hexagonal bolt, only one view is sufficient. Then the next step is determine the principal process. So principal process means which is going to be a major process. Whether turning, whether milling, or whether forming, or whether assembling. Yes.
Major in terms of what?
Means like suppose now in this component, I'll show you this component. In this component, which process is going to be a major process? Obviously, turning, isn't it? Obviously, turning, isn't it? Like this is turned, this is turned, this is turned, this bore is turned, isn't it? So almost 70% of this component is done by turning. Then there is a milling operation also, but that is only this square. And there is a drilling operation also, but that is only these four holes. So which is the major operation, principal process operation? You will say your turn. Understand? Suppose if it is a gear, then in that case, what is the principal process? Gear hobbing or gear shaping. Understand?
Yes, sir.
Hello. Yeah. So that is what you have to determine, the what is the purpose of this determining the principal process, so that you pay more attention to that process. Understand? Means as a process engineer, you have to establish this turning process properly. You have to pay attention to that, because majority of the operations are done by turning. So more time is consumed there. So as a process engineer, you have to minimize that time, as well as these are the critical operations also, because the tolerances, all the tolerances are going to be maintained in turning or maybe grinding. You have to pay attention to that. Whereas drilling, just char holi hai. Okay.
So it is these types of components can be made from milling also, na?
Sorry?
These type of components can be made from milling also, na?
No, in this component, see, it is going to be a cast. See, the basic process is cast. The casting is going to give the shape to this component. Okay. And then the milling is done only for the square. Understand? Because the quantity is 5000 pieces. You are not going to make from the round bar. So the basic process is cast, which is going to give the shape, and then milling is just these four holes, and drilling is only these four holes. So if you pay good attention to the drilling, you may be able to save only 5 seconds or 10 seconds. But if you pay more attention to the turning, you may be able to save 1 minute or 2 minutes, because turning is the major operation. Okay. Any other doubts?
No.
Okay, we'll continue next time. So we have come till here, determine the process, principal process. I'll upload this on the classroom.
And also, sir, wo Donald Eyre wala book tha na, wo online nahi mil raha, sir.
Nahi, uska soft copy nahi hai. But there are plenty of copies in our library, and the library is open.
Sir, par aapke paas hai
kya? Only, sorry?
Aapke paas hai wo book?
मेरे पास एक्चुअली आई हैव गिवन टू द वन ऑफ द स्टूडेंट आई विल हैव टू आस्क हिम ही हैज नॉट रिटर्न्ड इट कोई देते हैं मेनी ऑफ द बुक्स आर लाइंग विद द स्टूडेंट दे हैव नॉट रिटर्न्ड इट आई विल चेक अप विद हिम आई विल ट्राई टू गेट इट फ्रॉम हिम
पर नहीं सर मॉड्यूल 1 का सिर्फ मिल गया ना
हां वही हां क्या हो गया था वो केटी स्टूडेंट था ऐसे ही उसको बुक नहीं मिला था सो आई गेव हिम लास्ट सेमेस्टर में जब कॉलेज चालू था तो फिर बाद में वो लॉकडाउन में वो भी भूल गया होगा और मैं भी भूल गया आई विल ट्राई टू गेट इट फ्रॉम हिम एंड देन उसका फोटोज निकाल के मैं भेज देता हूँ
ओके सर
ओके
यस
ठीक है थैंक यू सो मच और कुछ
प्लीज शेयर द क्लासरूम इनवाइट ऑन माय ईमेल आईडी प्लीज
यस 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 यस
थैंक यू सर
थैंक यू